Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.2 Beta 3 to developers. Now this will probably be out to public beta testers soon, and along with this, Apple sort of released iOS 14.1. So 14.1 was released in the sense that it was on their website, but it wasn't available for the general public using iTunes or using your phone to check with software update. And so it's kind of strange they released it, then they pulled it, and we're not going to see that maybe until tomorrow or later on. Now, this particular update comes in at 626.6 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It's similarly sized on the iPhone 11, the iPad Air 2, and the iPhone 7, which is taking ages to install. In fact, that's been installing for over an hour at this point, and the iPad Air 2 also took quite a long time. For some reason, this was a very long install. Now, along with this, Apple also released tvOS 14.2 Beta 2 or Beta 3, along with iPadOS 14.2 Beta 3 and watchOS 7.1 Beta 3. So all of those are out. There's no signs of macOS Big Sur Beta 10 or a GM or anything like that. So it's kind of an odd day for updates, along with all the huge updates that Apple made with the iPhone 12. But let's talk about the build number, and then we'll talk about anything new in here, as well as the iPhone 12 launch. Now let's go into settings. We'll go to general, go to about. You can see the build number is 18B5072F. And this particular build does not have a ton new in it, but it does have a new modem update. So if you were having connectivity issues with beta 2, hopefully it will be more resolved with this particular update. And going into the iPhone 12, it looks like they have Qualcomm modem. So most of those connectivity issues we've had for the past couple years with Intel modems should be fixed. So I'm really looking forward to those. Now, there are a couple small updates in this particular update, and what that means is when you connect a wireless device, maybe a Bluetooth device, such as the newly announced HomePod Mini, or maybe the Beats Flex that they announced. They didn't announce those at the event, but they went live on Apple's website. You have a new icon set for that. So, of course, you'll need that when you connect to your device. So that will be available similarly when you connect your iPad or your AirPods rather to your iPhone or your iPad. You get a little window here, and this doesn't have the shadow on it either anymore. They've fixed that. But as you can see here, we have the AirPods 2 connected and it's showing the icons. We'll see those when we get the new HomePod Mini as well as the Beats Flex. So those have been found in the code thanks to my friend Steve Moser. Now, one feature they did implement in this particular update has to do with HomePod Mini, and that is intercom. So you can use your phone to announce to other people that you need to get going. So if you have a HomePod at home, you can say some keywords and then actually tell it to let everyone know around the house that it's time to go, and it will sort of use them as intercom. So you've got HomePod Mini, and this particular update enables that for everyone. So it will work on iPhone and iPad and the others as well. Now, this isn't really a feature, but there is one good thing, and that's if you use WhatsApp, videos can now be played. So if you're using WhatsApp and we're having issues with videos, it appears that the problem was with iOS, not with WhatsApp. So let me know if that's working properly for you in the comments below, but it definitely should be working properly. And some people are seeing some slight changes in music when on the lock screen. So if I go to the lock screen, you can see the actual length of the album playing. I saw this in previous betas, but some people are now seeing it. So it seems like it may be fixed for some people, or that's just the way Apple's been playing around with it in different versions. So we know that there's changes in the control center, so it seems like they've updated that now too. Now, aside from that, there are new core media features for developers. Now you can't see these, but this allows for different media, similarly playing media at the same time, and some things that developers can use to make your experience better, but not anything that you're going to see physically. Now, as far as other features or anything new, I have not been able to find anything new throughout this OS. In fact, there's nothing that seems different. Maybe some animation speeds when we move, just like that, when I move to bring down Siri search, but I'm not really seeing anything specific or new. So that's kind of interesting. Now, within this particular update, Apple has resolved four issues with Swift UI. So if you were having issues and you're a programmer with Swift UI, there should be resolved issues, but there's also some known issues, and they're kind of odd. So for example, if you have an iPad Pro 11-inch second gen or fourth gen iPad Pro 12.9, you can't actually get the restore images to restore it on your computer. The only way to update is to go to settings and then go to software update. And that's the only way you can do that. So for whatever reason, those are not found. They got rid of them. Hopefully they'll be available in a future update, but right now they're not available. Now we'll probably see a lot more updates in iOS 14.2 beta 4 on a weekly schedule, which I would expect next week. And I would expect more things like their new products, new icons for iPhone 12, iPhone 12 mini, iPhone 12 Pro, and iPhone 12 Pro Max. If you didn't see any of those updates, go to Safari. And at apple.com, you can see all of the new updates, the iPhone 12, 12 Pro, the new MagSafe accessories, HomePod mini, and more. So there's accessories and things like that. So that was a pretty big announcement today. This is a pretty minor announcement. But in using this over the past few days, Apple did release an update for watchOS just yesterday, and they fixed battery issues. So I'm hoping this update, as well as iOS 14.1, fixes battery issues as well. So if we go into settings, we'll take a look at my battery here. We'll go down to battery, battery health. You'll see battery health is at 94%. That's pretty good after over a year. I've talked about that extensively in the past, but let's take a look at yesterday's battery life. Was not great at all. 2 hours and 4 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 24 minutes of screen off time using 50% of my battery. Typically, I do get a lot more, like the day before. 3 hours and 22 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 15 minutes of screen off time. And I didn't even use 25% of my battery. That's more like what we expect for battery life with this phone. So depending on what you're doing day to day, you can see I used a lot of messages that day. But depending on what you're doing, expect 10 to 12 hours of battery life now. Hopefully we'll see that. Now, as far as performance does seem to be really great. I haven't had any slowdowns. And even on the iPad Air 2, which there are no updates with iPad OS, it seems, there are no other updates other than what I've already mentioned. You can see that it's nice and fast, although my widgets have disappeared. So for some reason, they just went away. I had some widgets here and they're gone. So you will have to re-add those on this particular beta. So something's up with that. But like I said, performance seems nice and smooth. If we go to the iPhone 11, you're going to have the similar performance that you get with the iPhone 11 Pro Max, of course. As we scroll through, you'll see things are nice and fast. Don't expect any slowdowns whatsoever. It's the first time I'm loading music. Everything's nice and fast. Now with the iPhone 7, let's try that out since it just finally rebooted and installed. Let me unlock it here. Now that it's unlocked, it should be fairly slow as it's probably doing a lot of background processing, and the back of this is quite warm. I noticed that on all of these models because I ran a Geekbench afterward and they were horrible scores. I'll talk about in a moment, but I think that's because it was so warm. So you'll see this one has been updated and everything's nice and fast, at least for the first time updating. It's going to take a moment. There we go. It's not bad considering that it's still so warm. It's going to throttle the processor when it's that warm. So in general, it should be pretty good, but I'm hoping to see iOS 14.2 beta 4 as early as next week, because now we're at the fourth beta. We may be on a weekly cycle, and we'll probably see that to coincide with some of the releases of iPhone. So with iPhone or iOS 14.1, maybe we'll have 14.2 ready to go when iPhone 12 launches, but we'll have to wait and see what Apple does with that. And so I'm really excited about all the iPhone 12 launches, all of the things they showed off, and I'm really looking forward to getting my hands on the iPhone 12 Pro Max with that incredible camera. If you haven't seen the information about that camera looks incredible. It has Dolby Vision support, and you do have that blue color, as you can see here, that was rumored before. So I'm really looking forward to that. Let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below. So now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores and see what we've got now that the devices have cooled down. As you can see, benchmarks have completed on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, as well as the other devices I have here. And for the iPhone 11 Pro Max, you'll see that the single core score is 1,330, where multi-core is 3,219. Now I suspect a lot is going on in the background because this is the third time I've run it and the scores are just not that great, but they keep improving as I run it. As you can see, here's the first run, which is really low, only in the 2000s for multi-core, and then it goes up to the 3000s. So I would expect expect as the day goes on and background tasks are completed, it will improve. But here are the other scores just for reference, and these are not that great, and I think that's because it's doing a lot of background processing. So on the left, I have the iPad Air 2 with 383 and 1,051 for multi-core. And then I have the iPhone 7 with only 323 for single core, 699 for multi-core, and then the iPhone 11 with 1,331 and 3,268. So again, not great scores for this particular update. So that's it for iOS 14.2 Beta 3. Now, hopefully we'll see Beta 4 as soon as next week if Apple is switching to a weekly cycle. And then again, iOS 14.1 is kind of odd. In fact, you're able to install it if you had the IPSW file and if you were able to download it, but after they pulled it, you can't get it from anywhere. So it might be available tomorrow. I would really like to see that released to the public. In fact, I'm already running it on my iPhone 11 Pro. And so hopefully we'll see that soon with all of the updates and changes. Some people are speculating that it's just for the iPhone 12 and will release when that releases, but it looks like it's ready to go. It doesn't have a letter at the end of the build number, and it should be ready. So hopefully we'll see that very soon. And if we do, of course, I'll keep you updated here as well. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.